But anyway, yeah, it's just, it's amazing stuff, and it makes me so happy to see the truth, you know? So, there's some good books you can read, too. If you're going to read about gangbanging, I'd start with Do or Die. A woman named Leon Bing wrote that book back in the late 80s, early 90s. I think it came out in 91. But I read that book probably 10 different times. Each time I learned more from it. And the woman just went out on her own and started linking up, meeting different Crips, different Bloods, you know, and, all around South Central, and let them speak for themselves, and wrote about it in the book, and gave them a voice, you know, and I had to respect that woman for that. I mean, because, you know, the world condemns the people like that. Not everybody, but plenty of people just can't, you know, can't fathom somebody doing that, actually caring about gangbangers, actually showing love to them, caring about them. I mean, but I think all these fake Christians in this country, you know, it mentions that in the book that one dude, I think his name was B-Dog, said that he's been in malls and stuff like that before and seen people from churches, proselytizing in there, and said, saying, oh, can I talk to you about Jesus and this and that? Only the well-dressed people, only the white people. And then they see them and they run away from them. I mean, now what does that tell you about what kind of Christian they are? You know, there's true Christians and there's fake Christians, in my opinion. You know, there's church doctrine Christians that believe every word in the Bible, even though it isn't, not every word is true. Only a few sections are worth reading in that book anyway. There's not much you have to do. Treat others as you want to be treated. Don't judge people. Don't condemn people. Show love all the time. And don't fight back, you know, because the universe will deal with it. You know, that's the only thing that matters in that book. That's it. The other stuff about hell and all this stuff and all these prohibitions is a bunch of shit. I can tell you that for a fact. I can tell you that the universe doesn't care what words you use. The universe couldn't give a damn if you say fuck or shit, motherfucker, pussy, dick, whatever. Words like that, you know, the universe doesn't care. They're just words, little utterances of noise. You know, it's what's in your heart that matters to the universe, really. But look at that, you know. I have the book here right now. I have the book right here. This is the book right here, Do or Die. And I bought my own copy of it at Barnes & Noble along with several other books the other night. But before I walk this dog, let me read this right here, you know? I want to read about what happened, you know, with the guy, what he said about the guy in the mall. Let me see if I can find that. Alright, here we go. Alright. Yeah, the guy's name was B-Dog. Now, he might have crossed over, he might not have. He probably hasn't. I don't really feel like he has, but I'm not sure. I don't really sense him. But anyway, because he got out of the gangbanging businesses at the time of this book, but anyway, let me read this so I can walk the dog. It says, Ryder pins me with an intense gaze. Let me tell you something I see way too much of. Sometimes I'd be in a mall with a couple of the homies, and we'll be loped out in khakis and shades and stuff, and we'll see some church people there. Folks will be walking by, and the church people will walk up to them. Ryder alters the pitch of his voice slightly. Excuse me, brother, can I talk to you all for a minute about Jesus? And then they'll always grab onto someone who's real clean cut to witness Jesus about. You know what I'm saying? And then here we come. Ryder's shoulders perform a slight weaving motion, rolling from side to side as if he were walking. But they won't say nothing to us, won't even get caught looking at us. So I walk up onto him and I say, how about me? I'm not worthy of God. How come y'all don't witness to me? He's just wearily in the chair. He looks sad, suddenly, and much older. To me, they should be looking for the so-called sinner instead of the clean-cut one, probably already a Christian. I tell preachers this all the time, because when they see us, they quick look the other way. Ryder mimes a person shrinking away from something that repels and frightens him. His action is purposely overstated, and it merits a laugh from B-Dog. But actually, I messed it up. It is Ryder who said that about the other one. Anyway, but the point is, let me keep reading this. But Ryder's playing it for laughs. He continues to look at me, and his voice assumes a plaintive tone. I ask them, isn't Christianity about saving souls, or are you only looking for people who are already converted? I ask them, if they're such strong Christians, why are they so afraid of us? It ain't like gangbangers as the lions in this coliseum. See, that man was smart, you know. They're not idiots, you know. They're not stupid people. They're not worthless people. Man, they love each other. They show love to one another. They help each other out. They're not some demon in disguise. And you have to open your mind up more to everything. You can't leave out any kind of people. If you're going to be spiritual or practice any kind of spirituality, whatever you call it, whatever religion it might be or lack of it, it might just be you're inwardly spiritual like me. But practice what you preach. Don't be afraid of people. You know, show love to people without fear. That's all. That's all I gotta say. Let me go take Scout out for a walk, and we'll get back with you later. Peace.